was me you're looking for. Robin's gonna love this.
Experimental.
Lad.
Inspiring.
Stunning.
Old.
Hilarious.
Robbo.
Amazeballs.
Awesome.
Hormonal.
He's bald.
Lad.
Mel.
Big toddler.
Caring. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Comic trooper.
Godlike.
Don't know. Compassionate.
Exhilarating. Adequate.
I agree to be a better person, and I thank him for that.
Bit of a legend.
Embarrassment.
He's alright.
Gangster.
Curvation.
Nice, friendly guy.
He's bouncy.
He's unique.
Bald.
Bird's eye.
Neighbour.
Flexible.
He's very flexible with his appointments, is what I was getting at.
Alright.
He's God.
He looks like a baby.
Perky.
Inspirational.
Awesome. Simple.
Amusing.
Very random.
I don't have anything to say.
Hero.
I'd say he's quite wacky.
Yes, wacky, very wacky.
Jolly.
Indescribable.
Enigmatic.
You're actually probably the most funniest teacher I've ever known.
What would you say was your favourite memory from the 2 years of sixth form?
Many memories. I've got to admit, the Wild West social, the end of the Wild West social, and a certain young man enjoying himself on the dance floor, and then calling me dad, when I clearly wasn't his dad. He said, "You remember that, James?"
I don't.
There you go.
Thank you, Arnold, wanting to borrow a t-shirt to go clubbing.
Christmas this year, when we did the Just Dance, Amy Clark was just wiping the floor with everybody. And all she was doing was like moving her wrist. She wasn't actually dancing at all.
Ben Hardman also saying to me, "Mr. Blackband, when I'm no longer a small little boy, I want to be exactly like you." So Ben Hardman, he's a mini Ben Blackband.
So, are there any particular funny moments you've had in the maths lessons?
Well, it's maths, isn't it? So.
And lots of the boys like to go on joint toilet trips, so I will miss that.
There's only one Mike, Stacey.
Lawrence Clemson, every excuse under the sun, always leaves his homework in the boot of somebody's car, usually hungover.
The first dinner dance that I went to was quite amusing, seeing everyone stumble in. Laura Noakes.
Tom Bullock. To sum up Tom in one word, I would have to say Mankini.
I think my favourite moment was coming back, having been away for a couple of days, and finding that my entire room had been covered with snail posters in protest to the fact that I had euthanized my snails.
Tristan, the most diligent person alive. One for the girls there. If you want to pick a husband, you've got to pick Tristan. He's steady Eddie, and he can't lie. So that's Ina Price, along with Tristan. They'll probably get married.
When Gemma came into my office, and Gemma said, "I've kicked a girl in the head and I did it really well," and she's the only person who could ever come into an office and be congratulated for that as an international kickboxer.
Becky Pryor. What are we going to do with you, Becky?
I think the Zumba's been quite amusing as well. Gav's.
Shakeshaft coming up to me at the sci-fi social, again, slightly worse for wear, and he said to me, "Mr. Robinson, I know I've been a nightmare, I know I haven't done any homework, I know I haven't attended lessons, but I am exceptionally good looking."
I'll miss Jess. No, I will miss Jess, but didn't see much of Jess, so.
I'll miss this group of boys who like to wear their hoods up, but poke their little ears out. Ella's such a lovely, caring, special person. She needs to believe in her abilities.
Stop crying, Ella!
I'll miss Sam smoking in due to time.
Chris Marnie. Who's that?
It does, it feels like the end of an era for me. It feels very, very sad.
All of you, best of luck for all of your exams. I wish you every success in everything that you do.
I think we're a lovely teacher group, lovely bunch of people, and I've enjoyed every moment.
Good luck. I hope everything goes well with you in your future, and I hope you look back on Ashcombe with fond memories.
Hi there, everybody. How are you? Now, many years of being here, teaching for ages. What can I say about my Upper 6 Economist and Business Studies apart from bye-bye, we'll miss you all, seen loads of you, had lots of fun, and have a fantastic life. Bye!
But obviously I wish them all the best.
I'll just miss all of you, and I hope you all the best and great happiness in the future.
Yeah, it's been a good 2 years. I've enjoyed working with them, teaching them some maths. Best of luck for the future, basically. Enjoy university, don't do anything too stupid. Come back and visit at some point.
I'm going to miss all of them. But mostly I just want them to, you know, enjoy the rest of their lives, have fun.
Good luck, guys. I'm really going to miss you.
My last message from the sixth form would be, don't take yourself too seriously. Work hard, play hard, and if any of you in the future have maybe a boy or a girl, maybe a sixth form lady, if any of you want to use the name Jane.
It's been hard work, but it's been a privilege and I've been very proud.
The next 6 of them aren't as good as us because they won't be, so it's about it.